Digi-Key is on a mission to make technology accessible to everyone, to bridge the gap between hardware and software, democratize the world of electronics, and inspire the next generation of STEM programs. In this three-part series brought to you by Supply Frame, Digi-Key, and Microchip Technology, we follow the path of students, educators, entrepreneurs, startups, and the makers of tomorrow. In this episode, we learn about Arduino's role in the world of academia. Our journey took us from the prestigious labs of CalTech to a grade school classroom where a teacher introduces his young students to the exciting world of electronics. For our first stop, we met up with Sina, a grad student in bioengineering, who explained how him and his team is drastically reducing the cost of single-cell biology experiments with this open-source project.
So there's this really, really exciting field called single-cell biology in which you can study individual cells at like a very, very massive scale. And you can study more specifically the RNA content in a cell. So, you know, every cell has DNA. You can think of that as like the hard disk of a computer. But then in order to perform functions, the cell has to produce RNA, which is like the RAM of a computer. And a lot of the technologies to encapsulate individual cells, because the reaction happens within these really, really small droplets, a lot of this technology is microfluidics based. The experiments are quite expensive. You need pumps that are like $5,000 to $10,000 just for like an array of them. And so I thought that to make a much, much cheaper version of these pumps. And so that's what we did. So what we have right here is the Poseidon syringe pump with an added feature of a rotary optical encoder. And so that allows us to know the displacement of the sled, which allows us to really dispense accurate flow rates from the syringe. And it's all controlled by a GUI, which is designed using PyQt. It uses an Arduino with a CNC motor shield and a CNC stepper driver in order to control the motor itself. And we proved that it worked. We proved that we get as good results using these $30 pumps as we can with, like, for example, a $5,000 pump. But if we can really validate these tools, we can do it for quite cheaply, and we can get users to adopt them and improve on them and build upon them to do more complex experiments that you cannot do otherwise, that is really the goal. And that to me is like, it's like really, really exciting and super inspiring. So that's why I work on these projects.
Our last stop on campus took us to Dr. Mello, who leads students through the storied ME72 robotics competition.
I can tell you that in the early years when some of the courses that I now teach were offered, one of which has a 35-year legacy. We call it ME72, Engineering Design Laboratory. In the early years, the robots had to be tethered. With the onset of more advanced electronic devices, we now can do that remotely with radio control. And to that end, Arduino and other microprocessor platforms play an integral role in the communication protocols and the language required to get these devices to talk to each other. The beauty of modern day digital electronics, the absolute beauty and enabler, is that everything has been wonderfully produced in a building block format. We'll leave it to the electrical engineers to build and optimize and fabricate stepper motors. We don't need to concern ourselves with every detail and nuance.
Arduinos have definitely affected people's choices in the major that they're going to graduate with and also in the career. In fact, a lot of engineering schools use Arduinos to overcome the fear of handling pre-built PC boards and also to introduce the concept of embedded engineering to students. And the first step will be to spread word of how easy electronics is. And Arduino is helping us with this message tremendously.
Finally, we stepped into Jason Shine's classroom at Bryson Huell in Burbank, California. As the lead teacher here, he introduces his elementary students to the world of electronics with his creative projects.
And the school here is mostly actors, musicians, and artists, and found recently that these students are interested in technology as well. It's been really interesting watching STEM turn into STEAM. And the art aspect of it just is a natural fit. And it's been pretty exciting. I think people who are artists now can understand and appreciate that the technological aspect of it is also kind of a form of art. I know a lot of schools have had robot programs. The biggest one is Lego Mindstorms. I've been teaching that for summer programs for over a decade. And it's amazing. It's really, really incredible, but it's also really limiting and really expensive. So what I found is with the advent of Arduino and with it becoming so much cheaper and open source, is that for teachers who want to teach the technological aspect in coding, the limits are, they're really what you can do is limitless, and the cost is just so cheap. Figured, hey, well, why don't we learn and save money? So we got a digital force gauge that's got an analog digital converter. And so the kids are going to be soldering these pieces together with some four conductor wire to a nano and a screw terminal. And once they've got it running, they'll calibrate it, have it measure their weight, and they work in teams to set up this crate, same situation here, and they can check their theoretical numbers with their measurements and see how accurate they are. I think they're pretty excited about that. But when you have students type something in a computer and then a light turns a pretty color, or their favorite song plays, or you press a button, something happens, it's just really engaging. There's just so much stimulus and response with it. I think that's what they like.
Digi-Key provides instant access to products like Arduino that fuel innovation in STEM education, startups, and creators around the world. Accessibility to Arduino has set them apart in the world of modern electronics development.